column in simple construction. A column or a compression member in simple construction will subject not only by predominantly compression or axial compression, but also subject to bending moment, which is induced by the existence of eccentricity. An example of eccentricity a column, and then a beam. So the normal axis of the column, and then the distance to where the load transfer, eccentricity. So the bending moment pull to the, if it is force acting downward, F times A. Number one, a beam that simply rests on a column cap or column bearing. So the eccentricity of the force transfer from the beam to column is on the face of the plate bearing. So in this case, E here is equal to H over 2. Then the bending moment that derived from this eccentricity is the, if it is force acting downward, is F times E about y axis. Bending moment is about y axis. From top view, it is like column cap, blue color, column plate bearing, and then the is less on the top of it. So the axis here is the y axis. 2. To beam simply rest on the column bed bearing or column cap, then in different direction. So the eccentricity from the face of the plate bearing. So E is equal to B over 2. And then the bending moment derived from this arrangement, moment about Z, B over 2. The F times the E. From the top view, the beam. So the axis is about ZZ axis bending. Number 4 and number 3. The beam is connected to the flanks of the column. The eccentricity is about 100 millimeter. From the face of the flanks. So E here is equal to H over 2 plus 100. So the bending moment that derived from this measurement is about Y axis F times. And number 4, the beam is connected to the flanks, to the web of the column. normal exists, and the eccentricity to the normal exists is the this. So E here is equal to TW over 2 plus 100. Sorry, what is equal to TW over 100 over 2 is equal to TW over 2 plus 100, then the bending moment is about Z exists F times Z.
So then we will have a different value of eccentricity. So in order to determine or to verify whether the column it has sufficient or sufficient design resistance to compression axial and also nominal bending moment, we can verify the design resistance using this clause 6.3.3 of Eurocode 3 part 1.1. But in this clause, the correlation between each parameter is very complicated. There is an interactive formula that can be used to determine whether the column it has sufficient axial compression and bending moment design resistance. So the N ED over N BRD plus MYED over MYBRD plus 1.5 MZED over modulus plastic about Z times Fy, and it should less than equal 1.0. And it is an interactive expression, so by using this we can use to determine design resistance. So you can see here we have three components. Number one, this number one is this one. Number two and number three here. You can see here it is a part of clause 6.3.1. Then MYBRD is clause 6.3.2.3, and then this one is a design cross section design resistance to bending moment clause 6.2.5. So then the process we have discussed previously in the early topic and need to be highlighted here, that's the NBRD here is taken from the minimum value of NYBRD. NYBRD. Or NZBRD. Okay, that's all for this topic. We will continue with example. Thank you for watching.